That's my baby. That's why I work one-on-one with real estate agents to help them achieve the freedoms they want in their business, market-proof what they're doing, increase their profitability, and understand where they want to go, what goals they've set for themselves, how can we get there, and what's stopping them from getting there today. We'll talk about four major frameworks that are the foundation of my business, how I've utilized them, and how you can utilize them to achieve those freedoms. The first are my five values. These are non-negotiable for me. Throughout my career, I've realized the value of each of these when one or many of them were not present. I knew that I needed it, and I made them non-negotiables for everybody that I work with, partner with, as a client of mine, that I consult with, because without them, something is missing, and I can't accomplish what I want to accomplish, and I can't help you get to where you want if these aren't at least important and a level of emphasis for you. So first, collaboration. We work together. Forget about competition. It's easy to kind of get bogged down and say, well, I need to be better than this person. Collaboration. Doesn't matter who gets the pat on the back, who gets the credit. Let's work together. Let's find a common goal. Same with accountability. That if I say I'm going to do something by Friday at noon, it's going to happen Friday by noon. Or there's been plenty of time that I'm going to tell you, I know we talked about Friday at noon. It's not going to happen anymore. Here's the contingency. Here's what we're going to do instead. We're going to make arrangements beforehand. It's not going to just come and go, and a deadline's going to be missed. I have that because of my drive. I always am pushing for better, always pushing to get things done, do things more effectively, do things more timely, do things at less of a cost. So I get that drive to keep getting better, to be accountable, to keep working with others. And I have that because of excellence. And that's not just being excellent in general. It's being my top, doing with the best I can today with the understanding and that continuous improvement piece. It's always going to get better. I've got trust listed last and highlighted because there's a piece of trust in all of us that we need to have trust in each other as a team, if we're working one-on-one, if we're working in some sort of capacity together as colleagues, because if we don't, then it doesn't really matter if the other says they're accountable, the other says they're doing their best, they're working their hardest, because if we don't trust, that's not going to work out. So I walk into each of my game engagements with complete trust, and I expect my clients to expect that of me, to fulfill on the goals, expectations, on the commitments that we have for each other. So after each of the frameworks, I'll just have a quick thought. Some of the feedback I've got is, well, how can I put this into play today, tomorrow, next week? List 3 to 6 values that are important to you. Start looking for clients that have them. Identify your ideal clients around those values. Anything less than 3 is fine, but you really want to try to get to 3. Anything more than 6, 6 to 10 is a lot, but if they truly are important to you, write out a mission statement, write out those 5 values for you, and then target and relentlessly pursue working with that ideal client of yours, because you'll find that once you have these similar values, that the work becomes a lot easier to complete and more, I don't want to say exciting, but you realize, like, yeah, this is what's really important, this is important to them, so let's get good outcomes for everybody.